The seismic retrofit of the 2-mile-long Antioch Bridge has been completed to make the bridge earthquake safe. Caltrans contractors were busy for 2 years. High above the ship traffic on the San Joaquin River, they lifted heavy steel beams and cross sections to reinforce 21 pier columns. On the Sherman Island side of the bridge, 116 columns were strengthened with steel outer coverings. At 41 piers, hydraulic jacks lifted the entire bridge up half an inch, so 82 seismic isolation bearings could be slid into place so they can absorb and dissipate the energy from any earthquake, preventing damage to the bridge.
Now the 15,000 motorists who drive over the nearly 2-mile-long bridge that connects Sacramento and Contra Costa counties can have the peace of mind that they are driving on the cutting edge of seismic technology.
Completing the seismic safety on the Antioch Bridge project brings us a step closer to achieving seismic retrofit on all of the bridges in the Bay Area.
After the Loma Prieta earthquake, engineers learned that even newer generation bridges needed seismic safety retrofitting. There was no money to pay for it on the Antioch Bridge or the Dumbarton Bridge. Toll hikes in 2010 helped cover the cost.
We want to say thank you also to the thousands, hundreds and thousands of Bay Area toll payers who have funded this project.
Now I'm privileged to invite you to join us on a tour so we can show you some of the elements of the seismic retrofit. And we've got three stops today. And the first one is just following the path through the gate here where we can access the scaffold to go up and look at some of the friction pendulum bearings on one of the piers, one of the 41 piers where we've replaced the bearings.
Well, this is thrilling, Amy. We get to meet again. I actually get to talk about the bridge like this. Yeah. So
cool.
Well, right over here is where all the action is. This is actually one of the smaller bearings on the bridge.
Okay.
This is our type 2. It's about 5.5 feet in diameter. It weighs about 5,000 pounds, so that's about as much as a Cadillac right there.
Yeah.
What it does is it isolates the superstructure from the substructure. So in an earthquake event, when the column wants to move back and forth like that, instead of accelerating the whole bridge and the superstructure, the column can move back and forth. It can move back and forth as much as 22 inches.
So for a 1,000-year earthquake,
yeah,
these will hold this bridge. They will enable it.
Yeah, these are designed to be able to allow the Antioch Bridge endure or withstand a 1,000-year seismic evaluation earthquake and not have the bridge collapse.
Yeah.
Next, a trek across the bridge to Sherman Island for a close-up look at the reinforced columns. Doing the work here, by law, also meant protecting the environment. Nests were built for owls and swallows off the bridge so they wouldn't nest on the bridge.
So they had a high-pressure line, water line, up in the bridge like this, and then they had a big, long pipe with a spray nozzle on the end that they could reach around the bottom and remove any nest starts from the bottom portal every day. Because once they get the nest, you can't tell whether there's an egg in it or not, and so you really can't disturb it, and you have to stay 50 feet away from it, which would immediately stop the project. We had to prevent nest starts on the bridge, because what the environmental regulations prohibit is any interference with nesting migratory birds, and the barn owls and the cliff swallows are all part of that migratory bird collection.
A similar retrofit of the Dumbarton Bridge will be complete in 2013. At the Antioch Bridge, Mark Jones reporting.